We're gonna go to Kevin now. Kevin is a father of three teenage daughters. He's also a veteran and he's a small business owner.
Ambassador Haley, so I've watched you in the debates and you've indicated that you support continuing the military aid and financial funding in Ukraine. I guess what I'm wondering is, just kind of given the United States, our national deficit, the inflation, the border crisis, at what point would you as president change your mind or reverse course on sending American tax dollars to Ukraine?
Well, first I have to say, girls love their dads. And remember, it's all about raising strong girls. Strong girls become strong women become strong leaders. And thank you for your service. As a military spouse, I very much appreciate what you and your family have sacrificed. The issue of Ukraine, I feel like President Biden and to some extent Congress has done a disservice to the American people. It's very important to be transparent when you're going to use tax dollars towards something that is not inside our country. So let's go back and look at how we started. We had no better friend at the United Nations in Ukraine. They voted with us on everything. They supported every cause we did. They were just a great pro-American friend. But here you have this pro-American, freedom-loving country who was invaded by a thug, and 500,000 people have died because of Putin. The Ukrainians are fighting for their very survival. But this is where this comes in. Dictators, thugs, and terrorists always tell you what they're going to do. They're actually very transparent. Hamas said they were going to invade Israel. China said they were going to invade Hong Kong. Both of those happened. Russia said they were going to invade Ukraine. We watched it. China said that Taiwan is next. We better believe them. Russia said once they take Ukraine, Poland and the Baltics are next. Those are NATO countries. That puts us at war. This is about preventing war. That's our goal all the time, prevent war. And so what you have is Congress telling you, do we support Ukraine or do we support Israel? Do we support Israel or do we close the border? They're lying to you. That's a false premise. First of all, securing the border is job number one. America's acting like it's September 10th, and we better remember what September 12th felt like. It only takes one person. Secondly, if we go and continue to support Ukraine, first of all, look at the fact that Putin has hit rock bottom. They've raised the draft age in Russia to 65. They're getting drones from Iran, missiles from North Korea. And Putin knew he was losing. That's what was happening. Putin and Iran are close. When Iran, which there would be no Hamas without Iran, when Hamas invaded Israel on October 7th, they invaded Israel on Putin's birthday. Who's the happiest person in the world right now? Putin. Why? Because America shifted from Ukraine towards Israel. We can't have war. If Congress, I don't believe in sending cash to any country, ever. You can't hold it accountable. It's not a good practice to do. Ukraine doesn't want troops on the ground. They want to defeat this themselves. They just need the equipment and ammunition to win. For us to support Ukraine, it's only 3.5% of our defense budget. The Europeans have paid in more, and they should. It's their neighborhood. If we support Ukraine and Israel, it's only 5% of our defense budget. And if we support Ukraine, Israel, and secure the border, which is job number one, it's less than 20% of Biden's green subsidies. So don't let them tell you that we can't do the one thing that government's supposed to do, which is protect Americans. National security is job number one. Keeping our country safe, keeping our children safe, and keeping us out of wars should always be a priority. We need to finish what we started in Ukraine. Because if we don't, I promise you a year from now, they're going to want to leave Israel. This war would have been over if Putin would just leave. The war would be over. If Ukraine stops fighting, they lose their country. That's what this comes down to. On September 12th, we needed a lot of friends. You have to be a friend to get a friend. America can never be so arrogant to think we don't need friends.